Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bright Ops, and welcome back to Elden Ring. Where, I will admit, we are briefly returning to the hold, because I'm not completely sure where...
Find the Albino. She hides in a cave to the west of the Lascia ruins, which jut from the mist-shrouded lake. She knows the look.
Okay, so Lascia ruins. Hides in a cave to the west of here. Okay. Cave, where is the... Just healing up the horse, because it took a mild hit. I don't think we've been here before, so... Lakeside Crystal Cave. So this looks promising. Shit. Fucking hopping on, stabbing me in the face. Before we go that way, let's see what's this one. Cave moss. Be wary of ambush. Took care of that. Bunch of silver fireflies, because why not? Bug oh bug. Spear talisman. Not bad. Right. Now comes the fun bit. Okay, that way equals death. Not here. Where of stink, by the way, no dog ahead. Good God, it's so... Considering everything we're used to fighting at this point, this is just so... pleasant. Just to come in, kill everything, leave. Be wary of left. Soft cotton. Smithing stone, lump of flesh. Boss ahead. Okay, so that is an Ember Medallion. Here we go, raises max FP. Oh, hello.
Foul tarnished. What do you want? I told the all-hearing brute that I possess no such medallion. Or have you come to take more from me? Was my other half not enough? Oh. Do you speak true? So old Albus entrusted his medallion to you. Then I've no choice. But to trust that this was his dying will. Let's try again. I'm Latena. An Albinoric, the same as old Albus. My apologies for my coarse words earlier. I presumed the worst. Seeing that you're another tarnished like that all-hearing brute, I hope that you will forgive me. The medallion's better off in your hands anyway. Would you consider doing me a great service? I must go back. There is something I must do. Even if I must say farewell to my wolf Loba, will you show me the way? To the land of Mikola's Halib tree. If you accept, I would gladly apprise you of the whereabouts of the medallion's other half. Thank you kindly. They say the other half of the medallion is beyond the Forbidden Lands, north of the Erdtree. In Castle Sol, on the mountaintops of the giants, accessible by the grand lift of Rold. Then I suppose it's farewell, Lobo. I will go with the Tarnished, so that I forgive me, Lobo.
I'm not sure if the Duggo is alive. I guess he's alive. Okay. I'm happy to just leave him. Okay, so let's see. Lux Ruins, where's the elevator? Grand Lift of Dextris there. So there's the Colosseum, but. So apparently we're a bit north of. Apparently the thing is meant to be a bit north of there. See, Dragon Borrowed to do. Yeah, there was something I wanted to. It wasn't. So where is it we wanted to go? Shack the Rotting? Ah, server here. Guess we missed a buddy. Oh well.
To pay a visit, hoping to find someone here, but I've only found emptiness. Perhaps before my departure, I needed someone to say farewell to. Well, never mind that. I must focus on my journey, for which I have you to thank. I must stay strong. Well, I must focus.
Okay. So she's traveling somewhere. I think I might have an idea as to where. Then I'm trying to work out which one was the. We'll just go with the ramparts. Because I think she wants to go in this direction. Because it was where we found a, you know, replacement limb. There was some just clearing some of the basilisks out. There was somewhere outside of this castle that had like messages saying friend here or something. Could be completely wrong and just going in the wrong direction. Just collecting flowers for the sake of it, really. Friend ahead, but off a critical hit. Someone mentioned the Noble Gold Mask. I guess we could go and stop by him again, but oh yeah, there was also bloody here. There was a we were waiting for something to come about. Oh, hello.
Thought I might find you here. I must admit, I was a little worried. We missed our meeting. But it looks like you're still in one piece, eh? You must have heard by now, right? That Star Scourge Radahn holds Rani's fate in stasis. But once he's out of the way, it'll spring back into motion. So now, we stand against the demigod once known as the strongest of them all. The way ahead is pleasingly simple. We fight. Sword and fang. Into the fray to get into the fray.
Welcome. The stars have aligned.
Oh.
The festival is nigh. General Radahn, mightiest demigod of the sea, awaits you. Champions, prepare. For battle! Defeat the general find glory and grab that great rune. A celebration of war. The Radahn Festival!
Ah, you came. How delightful. Indeed, I thought I might find you here. By the by, do you know for whom this festival is being held? Well, it is none other than General Radahn himself. To think, I could face a great champion of the Shattering, a demigod in the flesh. Oh, in truth, I quiver at the thought. Such is his frightful repute. But the fear simply assures me the ordeal is worth undertaking. Be sure to get a good vantage, my friend. I, Iron Fist Alexander, do hereby vow to unflinchingly brave this ordeal. Be sure to get...
Hello, we got more people. Polite bow. So who are you? Don't know who that is, but okay. Anyone else?
Are you good and prepared, young chum? The festival begins.
Ready as we'll ever be.
Before we begin, allow me to paint you the full picture. General Radahn is cursed ever to wander. Inside by Melania's scarlet rot, his wits are long gone. Now he gathers the corpses of former friends and foes alike, gorging on them like a dog. Howling at the sky.
But now, we must make merry. Oh, gathering of champions! The revels begin! The celebration of war! The Radahn Festival!
Hearten and cry.
You will find the field of battle past the church ahead, upon the shore under the fort. General Radahn is there, even now, divested of his wits, devouring corpses, and howling at the sky.
Well, guess it's time to go and say hello to one of the demigods. I guess that door just doesn't open. Oh good, we don't have to, you know, like it's all the way back to the next thing. Travel to another location. Yep. Oh god, I think... I think the fact that this spell allows you to have so many summons is a pretty good indicator of... Damn, we got stun locked. Okay, this is gonna be an uphill fight. Though, maybe once we actually get close to him, we don't necessarily have to... Ah, bugger. Oh wait, he's down. Is he dead? Is he dead? Let's find out. Not sure if that counts as a win for us or if he is gone. Let's find out. Nope. Got him! Remembrance of the Star Scourge. Okay. I think we just did something. A right mark was made on the map.
Ah, hello there. Well, it was a battle marvelously fought. You are well and truly a champion. I, on the other hand, am nothing but a crock. One hit was all it took to crack me, and for my inside to come spilling out. After that, I hid like a coward, and as such, I can hardly stand to face one such as you. But don't you think I've given up just yet? As luck would have it, there's a veritable mountain of warriors' bodies right here. If I can just squeeze this bunch down inside me, I'll be a mighty warrior again in no time. And you know, the bodies found here are exceedingly fine. Who could expect any less from the very warriors who fought in the Shattering, the greatest of all wars? Just you wait and see, friend. I'll grow even stronger. Just you wait when next we meet.
In fairness, I can't really fault him for, like, if you get hit, considering just how he was, how hard he was hitting and all that, just being struck a devastating blow like that, deciding to live is not a terrible idea.
Bodies found here. Who could expect any?
Just you wait.
Alright, forgot about the runes. If I recall, let's see, what have we...
Ah, good. I was waiting for you. What a sick way to fight, eh? The glory of the clash is shared. By Radahn. And you. And did you see that afterwards? A falling star right before our eyes. I can't fathom how Radahn was holding back something of that scale. He was a living legend if ever I saw one. And the path has now been cleared. To Nokra. Irani's fate will be decided. Let's meet where the falling star bit the earth. We'll take up our souls once more for Mistress Rani. Let's meet where we'll go into battle. My only purpose is to fight for Rani's fate. The curtain's rising. Let's meet where we'll go into battle. My only purpose, curtain's rising.
No, I don't particularly want to go to the entrance just yet. Because if I recall, there's still things to be found here. Sorry, just having a look to see if there was anyone else to talk to. See, somewhere in this direction is where the statue was pointing. So it should... Yes, it's up there. At least that's where the statue is. Let's see if we can reveal where we're meant to go. See, was there something hidden around this area? Because it seems like there's not. Right, maybe. Ah, right at the end. Right. All the way at the end. Actually, while I'm here and can remember it. Right, while I'm remembering to do it. Let's see. So those are those two. Where are the other ruins? Because we had some. So Ricard's, devoid of any benediction. Alright, Radahn's. The great ruin of the Shard Bearer Radahn, devoid of any benediction. Seek the divine tower of Cathlid, which stands upon the principle at the Dragonborough shore. And you, sir, the which stands upon the principle of the coast southwest of Liniendell. War Dead Catacombs. See, while I'm remembering it. Let's see. I don't have enough gold seeds for. No? Okie dokie! Okie dokie. Yeah. Good solid 30 dexterity. Actually, while I'm thinking about it. No, it wasn't. Here we go. Take the power of its namesake via finger reader. Remembrance of Scar Scourge Redan, hone into the Erd Tree. The power of its namesake can be unlocked by the finger reader. Alternatively, it can be used to gain a great bounty of runes. The Red Lion General wielded gravitational powers, which he learned in Stilia during his younger days. So he would never have to abandon his beloved, yet scrawny steed. Ah. I mean, I guess that makes sense why he has such a small horse. He's a guy who's bloody massive. But yeah, I guess him learning gravitational magic in the first place was literally him trying to, you know, lighten the load, as it were. So we're fighting ghosts in a warship. That seems to be the gist of what's happening right now. I'm not sure if they stop spawning after a while, or if they're just, or if just the scale of this fight is that they're jumping from one fight to the next. More of that, you pricks. Did I just glitch out you having a weapon or what? Not here. What exactly? Ambush. I'll come back for that, just... I mean, all credit to him, but probably being a ghost in that regard likely gives them a lot better, more maneuverability and ability to attack from different directions that you, than you normally would have if you were alive. I'm not entirely sure if just picking off these, if they just keep respawning or... if they're just popping out from fight, from, as I said, popping out from the fight with her. Two for the price of one. So from the looks of it, they don't stay dead. They just keep respawning. Sorry, I had just a brief moment of confusion because the message was still up, thus preventing me from actually attacking anyone. Okay, I can definitely see why people die in this that particular fight. Alright, and this leads to... but essentially Scarlet Rot. I think there's probably still some stuff down there. We completely forgot about him. Shit. Oh well. Taking a brief moment. Gravity well. Collapsing stars. This one was the one we just got, right? One of the glintstone sorceries that manipulates gravitational forces fires numerous gravitational projectiles. Any foe struck would be pulled towards the caster. Charging enhances potency. A gravitational technique mastered by the young Radan. I thank you for your tutelage, for now I can challenge the stars. Well, apparently he wasn't... lying, he apparently did. Just kept the heavens locked in. Locked in place. Seems this particular guy has his weapon glitched out. Like when he tries to swap from the bow to the sword. Okay, so it's basically the same spot, just from a different angle.
Uh,
God damn it. Damn spooky, scary ghosts. I mean, from the looks of it, they never... Yes, you can kill a number of them, but they just never stop spawning. Or maybe they do stop spawning, you just have to kill them fast enough. Or kill enough of them. God damn, you have to admit the Knights of Ragdon are pretty freaking tanky as hell. I mean, I guess it makes sense, they're literally the knights of like a proper warrior general demigod. But still. Gotcha! You ghostly prick. Wait, can I? No. Radio. We'll probably be jumping through there in a second, just seeing. Down you go. Redan Soldier Ashes. Let's see that. Okay. Ashen remains of which spirits here dwells. Used to summon the spirits of two of Ragdan's soldiers. Both spirits wield fiery weapons to perform powerful skills, such as their valor that they will immediately attack after being summoned. General Dan's soldiers were all reputed to be masterful warriors, and were popularly said that the Redmanes knew no weakness. Also, we have Latina. Latenia. A rare case of one who chose to become a spirit voluntarily. Latinia was renowned as a daft magic archer, but having lost her beloved wolf companion Lebeau, she cannot move from the place where she was summoned. Cocky prick. Thought you could get pull the bell out? Not in your life. Somewhere a heavy door is opened. That's my little reminder that an hour's gone by. Might as well push on, see what's waiting for us ahead. Tree ahead, so speak to Snake. Well, it managed to eat us. Well, on the plus side, we now have a good idea of what's to come. But until then, my name is Bright Ops. I look forward to hearing from you. Take care.